everyone, and God bless you. I'm Pastor Kevin. I want to quickly apologize to every one of you because I promise we will take our time to fast and to pray today. But I was not able to do that for two reasons. You know that the forecast typhoon will be coming to Taiwan. So because of that, my family were at home with me. And secondly, for the past 7 or 8 days now, I have been spending almost all the night praying, and my body physically were tired, so I needed rest, and I actually slept this morning. I really sleep. So please, I just want you to bear with me. But I have a word for you. But tomorrow, by the grace of God, we'll be taking our time to round up with the fasting and prayer. Remember, we are praying for wealth transfer. We are asking God for wealth transfer. We are believing God for wealth transfer. And I believe that what we have talked about so far, some of us will put it into practice. Remember, what you don't practice, you cannot experience. You know, the word of God is not just to read it and learn, but you have to put it into practice. All right? You have to apply it into your life. And I believe word transfer is coming, and it has started. I'm not just saying it's coming, it has started. If you have not experienced it, people have been experiencing it. I will give some testimony of people that have experienced it before, and you will experience it in the name of Jesus. But I want to read the very word of Jesus in the book of John 4, verse 38. He said, I sent you to harvest where you did not plant. Others have already done the work, and now you will get to gather the harvest. Let's read it from another translation or another version. See, I sent you to reap that for which you have not labored. Others have labored, and you have entered into their rest. My prayer for you, you will enter into the rest of unbelievers. Everything that they have been gathering, you begin to enjoy it because their wealth will be transferred to you in Jesus' name. I am praying right now for a miracle morning. I am asking God for a miracle morning, that the power that creates, that same power is released to work on your behalf right now. I command, I speak to the four cardinals of the earth, that money will come from the east, from the north, from the south, from the west to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Money will come from everywhere. Money will come from the east. Money will come from the north. Money will come from the south. Money will come from everywhere in the name of Jesus. The wealth of the unjust will be delivered to you. Money will begin to appear in your bank account. Money will begin to appear in your purses. Money will begin to appear in your bed. Money will begin to appear in your wardrobe. Money will begin to appear in your cars. Money will begin to appear everywhere. You begin to see money. I release that miraculous power, miraculous creative miracle. I release it now. Let the power of the Holy Ghost be released. That dunamis power to create is released now to work for your favor in the name of Jesus. Miracle money. If you are believing God for a miracle money, I want you to begin to decree and declare, I receive my miracle money. I receive my miracle money. I receive my miracle money in the name of Jesus. If you are trusting God for divine help, maybe you are sick in your body right now, I pray for you. I want you to say this with me. Sickness, you are a stranger in my body. You are a foreigner. My body is the habitation of the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit cannot live in my body, and you, devil, live in my body. You, stranger in my body, every stranger in my body, I command you right now, get out of my body. In the name of Jesus, every stranger in this body, I command this body. You hear me, body, hear me. I command every stranger in this body to get out. If you are depressed, you say depression go. If you are wherever it is, maybe it's a bad character, mention it and say go. Maybe it's a fibroid, say go. Maybe it's blindness, say go. Maybe it's deafness, say go. Maybe it's arthritis, say go. Mention the name of the sickness and say go. Maybe the enemy is molesting you in the dream. You are saying, you that spirit that is coming to have sex with me in the dream. Say in the name of Jesus and by the fire of the Holy Ghost, anytime you come close to me, the fire of God will consume you. Remember, the Bible says in the book of Hebrew that our God is a consuming fire. You say fire, consume that demonic forces in the name of Jesus. Maybe there is power that is fighting against you, demonic structure that the enemy have set apart to fight against you, and you are saying in the name of Jesus, you demonic forces, you kingdom of darkness, evil altars, demonic structure, here you are hereby destroyed in Jesus' name. I set you on fire in the name of Jesus, my dear friend. And as you begin to pray like that, every demonic structure will be set ablaze in Jesus' name. And if they have taken your name to voodoo, to sangoma, to demonic places, in the name of Jesus, I set that place on fire right now. You are free in Jesus' name. Maybe you need the power of the Holy Ghost. As you are looking at me right now, I want you to say with me, Holy Ghost, I need you. Sit on me. Sit on me. Sit on me. Holy Ghost, as they are saying this now, right now, I ask you to baptize them. I ask you to sit on them. I set their body, their tongue on fire. In the name of Jesus Christ, from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, the Holy Ghost envelop you right now. The Holy Ghost vitalize your body right now. The Holy Ghost take over right now in Jesus' name. I ask the Lord Almighty to bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My dear friend, I want you to know that we'll be praying together tomorrow. Our fasting and prayer will end tomorrow. If you want me to send you the link, please, I want you to write to me and say to me, man of God, send me the link of tomorrow. It's going to be 11 a.m. Taiwan time. We'll take time to pray together. Remember, we are in the season. We are in the season of supernatural favor. The word, the word transfer you have been hearing about, it will continue to come to you. A lot of people have experienced it. You are the next that will experience it. The word transfer we have been crying about, you are the next that will experience it in Jesus' name. I want to thank you for joining us to pray for the typhoon. We all saw what happened in Japan, and it was coming towards Taiwan. And even the government asked the people not to go to work. All right, but somebody said on Periscope, he said typhoon is coming. And I said to the person, yes, I know that typhoon is coming, but I have silenced the typhoon. And everybody began to pray. Yes, the typhoon is silenced. What happened? The typhoon. We are silence. I want you to know, even that thing that is going, they have a voice to hear. Typhoon have a voice. Hallelujah. The sickness have a voice. Poverty have a voice. If you say to poverty, enough is enough, get out. If you want to get married, maybe you have been praying, say to that your marital delay, enough is enough. I'm getting married now. I am getting married now. I am getting married now. And as you begin to say that, the Lord will confirm it. I want you to know that no word of God can fulfill themselves. We have to enforce it into fulfillment. Do you want the word of God to be fulfilled in your life? Pray the word. Confess the word. Think the word. Envision and see what you are about to have. Begin to see it. Until you see it, it will not become a reality. Until you are tired where you are not qualified to go to the next step in life. Until you are tired where you are now, you cannot move to the next step. Solomon became the wealthiest man. He did not labor for it. It is by favor. The Bible says, he said, the whole earth will come to hear what the Lord have put in his heart. But if you read that, the Bible says, as they were coming with spices, they were coming with gold, they were coming with silver, they were coming with diamond, they were coming with wolves, they were coming with all sort of things, until Solomon became worthy, that the silver and gold become like a dust to him. Why? People were coming and they were bringing the goods. That is the wealth transfer we are talking about. We'll talk about that tomorrow in the name of Jesus. But there is something that Solomon do that trigger God. He moved God into action. Solomon moved God. You see, someone said faith moved God into action. Faith moved God into action. And I say this, your sacrifice can move God into action. It was Solomon's sacrifice that moved God, as God said to him, dear, what do you want? What do you want? He gave Solomon a blank check. He gave him a blank check. And Solomon said, I need an understanding heart so that I can be able to rule your people. You say, wow, you never ask for long life. You never ask your enemy to die. You never ask for this. I will give you wisdom and I will give you what you ask. And I will add to it wealth that no one on the earth will be like you. And exactly what happened. Exactly what happened. Solomon, according to the finding, still remained the richest man on the earth. His wealth. And do you know that the wealth of Solomon is still on the earth today? The wealth of Abraham is here. The wealth of Solomon is here. The wealth of Job is here. The wealth of the Egyptians is here. The wealth is still here. I mean, there are more wealth today on the earth than before. And you and I will begin to enjoy that wealth now. I'll see you tomorrow. Please, I want you to do me a favor. As you just watch this YouTube, send it to 8 people. 8 is a number of a new beginning. And as you follow this simple instruction, may the Lord give you a miracle in Jesus' name. And please, if you want to sow, send us any seed, or you want to invest into the kingdom, or you want to sow a seed into my life, what what you are seeing on the screen right now, you go to our website, or you want to send it through PayPal, just go there and send it to us. Remember, the seed you sow, the Bible says, be not deceived, for God is no more, for whatever a man soweth, he shall reap. If you sow, you will surely reap. God bless you. I'll see you tomorrow. Shalom.